Hi there, my name is Jennifer Forstinger and I am a therapist with Pathstone Mental Health. I am here today to talk to you about family routines. What we're going to be getting into is what are family routines, why are they helpful or beneficial, and some steps that I've put together to help you come up with family routines and routines for your children. And I also have an example of a visual routine, and I'm going to give some suggestions if that's something that's of interest to people. So routines are a way of completing something the same way every single time. So common routines that families might have are nighttime routines, or getting up in the morning and getting dressed routines. And they can be very simple or they can be more complex. More simple routines we would typically see with children that maybe need a little bit more assistance, or younger children. More complex and multi-step routines might be something that you might see more with kids who are a little bit more independent, or teenagers, or more so with parents and the routines that parents might have working with each other. Now, what can be really helpful about having family routines is that we as human beings thrive on having consistency and structure. It makes us feel good knowing what we need to do and when we need to do it. And it helps us acquire new skills, having routines and having a way of completing something the same way each and every time. It helps us to, you know, become and develop a sense of family camaraderie. You know, for routines like dinner time routine or bedtime story routine, those routines can help a family really feel like there's that shared goal for everyone that might be a part of the routine. Also having caregiver routines so that everyone knows maybe what their responsibilities are and when can be really, really helpful and can help minimize stress in the long term too. Now, maintaining normal routines and having some sense of routine and structure can help kids and adults with managing transitions and life changes that may happen. And that can be really, really helpful for us in general. As I mentioned earlier, having that sense of normalcy. Also, it can be really helpful for our internal clock if we have some sense of routine with when we wake up in the morning and when we go to bed. Now, I'm going to talk a little bit about how you can come up with some routines of your own for your family and for your child. I'm going to be speaking very, very generally about routines, but the same concepts can be applied to your family, or they can be applied to if you want to make a routine for your child. Now, the first step of coming up with a routine is thinking about what part of the day would be helpful to have more structure in. Thinking about the part of the day and then looking at what are our family's current habits. So that would be number two. What is it that we're currently doing at that time? I suggest thinking about what it is that you are doing before we implement something new, because it helps to think about kind of where our baseline is before we start changing something. Now, step number three, I want you to think about what your child's, you know, current developmental needs are and maybe what their mental health needs might require too. And this is something you can, of course, discuss with a mental health professional or your physician if you need more specific information. But as a caregiver, I think you know what it is, and you might have a sense of this on your own. So what I mean by that is thinking of, you know, what is it that you know your child can do individually? And what is it that, you know, they will need some assistance with? And sometimes it's helpful to consult a professional. Sometimes we can do a little bit of research and figure that out on our own. Now, if there is multiple routines, and I know for back to school, For many of us, there's different routines we're going to be adopting now that this is coming up. If there's multiple routines that we want to be adding in, I suggest to parents to pick one routine or one specific time and thinking about how we can automate that time to help make the biggest difference. Now, the reason I suggest picking one time is that change is something that can take time, and it's helpful if we adopt small habits and small changes that typically will make the biggest difference. So if we try and implement a routine for one specific area and we just focus on that for a month or however long it takes, that can be the most helpful than trying to do a couple. The other important piece that goes with that is typically adding in a new routine requires more legwork in the beginning as a parent and more energy and engagement. And my suggestion is for your relationship with your child, just start with one for the time being, because if you try and do too much too soon, it's gonna feel really hard and really frustrating, and that's kind of the opposite effect of what it is we're hoping to accomplish by cultivating routines. So the next step that's really important is think about how I can get my child's buy-in to this routine. So, you know, depending on how old your child is, adding things like Minecraft graphics, or if your child is really into anime, maybe seeing if you could get something with one of their favorite anime characters, or whatever it might be that they are really into, come up with a creative way of engaging them with some of their favorite characters and adding in, maybe making, if it's a visual routine, having some of those characters on it, thinking about how you want to reinforce the routine that you want to come up with too. So if we're using getting up in the morning, you know, reinforcing it first and foremost with verbal praise, noticing when your child is doing something well, pointing out really what it is that you're liking about their behavior, and continuing to tell them how proud you are. That can be really important going forward. Another thing that can be helpful is rewarding them with quality time. So thinking in terms of, you know, if you're able to complete this many times this week, we are gonna go and maybe go and come up with quality time, maybe together or cooking a favorite meal or something that's really meaningful as a reward that is really nice for everybody. Now, another thing too that you can do is come up with and ask your child what might be meaningful for them to help engage them. Some kids might not have any ideas, and that's okay too. Some might have some really good ideas or might think, you know what, I had a teacher at school that maybe did it this way or that way. You might get some good ideas that way. Now, once you have an idea about what time you're going to be doing this, and like, you know, your child's needs, and you think about, okay, how can I come up with a way of reinforcing it? The next step is to create, you know, a visual schedule. And the visual schedule is a great introductory step. You know, depending on how old your child is, the visual schedule may be something that stays with them for a little while. It might be something that, you know, if you have a teenager, maybe coming up with like an electronic schedule, that might be more their speed, or a day timer, or whatever it might be that really works with what their interests are, because we want them to be excited about it and we want them to see it as something that's good for them. Now, depending on their age and stage, having them maybe color it or decorate it, I know, like, this bullet journaling idea is also really popular with teenagers. So maybe they might want to doodle or incorporate elements of that into it too. So come up with something that really helps improve their buy-in. Now, things like Pinterest and Google can also give you some good ideas too about, you know, ways of making it really visually appealing. Now, the other important piece too is really committing to staying the course for a little while. As I mentioned earlier, long-term change is really the combination of daily habits and consistency, and sometimes doing the thing that maybe you don't want to do as much because you see that there's long-term benefit in choosing to do so. So continuing with the routine for a little while would be something we would recommend. Now, if you notice that, as an example, your child is really having a hard time with, you know, a part of the routine, or maybe you made an assumption about something that they could do and maybe they need a part of it broken down more, you can reevaluate and tweak it if you feel like that's required, but we recommend, if possible, committing to it for a little while, at least 2 weeks, and seeing kind of how that goes. Now, my suggestion too is, when you do decide to make changes, focus on what really went well about the routine, and then really, what could we improve upon? Now, I think it's also really important too to do that so that we learn something from the process and we get something out of the process, because even if the first routine we try isn't our long-term routine, we at least learn something out of the process that could be beneficial in developing that lifelong or that longer-term habit. Now, this is an example of an evening routine. Might be hard to see because it's laminated. Now, this evening routine might be like the family's evening routine, but maybe if your child is a little bit younger, they might, as an example, need a routine that's printed off in visual, just for brushing their teeth, as an example. You might have to break that down into more steps for them. And that's okay. You know, the purpose of this is to help acquire new skills. Some children will also need that cueing from caregivers to tell them, hey, you know, this is what, you know, is expected of you now. Or, you know, might need that help of, you know, are you able, do you know what step you need to do? And that's okay too. You know, allowing them to feel okay with asking questions and staying the course together is really what's most important. Now, this is everything that I have to share about family routines and coming up with individual routines. And really, you know, if you have any more questions about this topic, my suggestion would be to consult with your physician, mental health professional, or get some more assistance if you need some help kind of nailing this down and figuring out something that's solid for your family. But these are all of my tips and all of my steps that I use and I think about when I make routines. So I hope that this was helpful, and I hope that this serves you for this upcoming school year. Thank you and be well.